face the network, face to face.
Since he won that title, 1 month shy of being the only two-year champion in wrestling, and perhaps the last one we'll ever see, Rob Van Dam has relinquished the title.
And whoever it is that you think is gonna carry that world television belt, I want you to know that I'll be back to beat their f***ing ass to take my world
just saved this television show. What a selfless act by Rob Van Dam.
Can you imagine how badly he wanted to be a two-year champion? He was only one month away.
Get out of here, Fonzie! Who's got the belt right now, huh?
We're gonna see a fight over that belt right here and right now.
You wanna go with me, huh?
Cyrus and Fonzie.
Where again, Big Sal just mugging the insane luchador. Now what are they doing? Big Sal is in the ring. Guido up on the shoulders of Big Sal. Oh my, no. Oh my God, are you kidding me? Elbow off the shoulders of Big Sal, on the Super Crazy, through the table, all the way to the concrete floor. Crazy's rib cage may look like that table. And despite the fact that Guido had all of his weight across the shoulders and had hooked both legs, Crazy somehow managed to escape. Guido going for the Maritano. crazy now, looking for a counter. Elevator down. Crazy now going to the outside. Vaults. Moonsault, that may be all. No, went for another hit, the Quebrada. And picked up little Guido. He wants to use the same brainbuster, the same delayed brainbuster he used on Kid Cash. All the blood rushing to the head of the Sicilian shooter. Guido kicking his legs, wriggles free. Moratano, cover. And you can bet Guido will be looking for another shot at the ECW World Television title.
Guido! You give Belto to Rhino. Go on, hand it over. Like we talked about.
Tajiri had a very confused look on his face at this point. Confusion, and perhaps he was anxious. Either he did not understand what Cyrus was asking him to do, or Tajiri understood perfectly what Cyrus wanted from him.
You don't understand. Let me put it in terms that you and everyone else can understand. You don't embarrass me on the network, you slanty eye. Listen, you damn ingrate. I can pull your work visa and you'll be driving a bicycle delivering chop suey. Problem. Hand up. No, you hand the belt over. What about me? I looked after you, little sucky sucky in the limousine after we put the title on you, huh? Huh? Do you know who I am? Do you know who I am?
Sounds like they know exactly who you are, Mr. Network Suck Up.
I'm the damn network, and you're a piece of meat that I put in front of that camera to pop a rating. Now, you are gonna hand that belt to Rhino. Now. I'm gonna ask you one more time. What is your answer?
We didn't think they had the letter F in Japanese. Now, this is the way championships are decided here at ECW. Championships are won and lost in the ring. Rhino counter the DDT, and Tajiri locked on the octopus. It looked like the matchup was all but won. Steve Corino in the ring. Takes the green mist right in the face. Tajiri then taking out Corino. And Jack victory. But Rhino capitalized on the distraction and gored Tajiri in half. Pile driver. That had to be all, right? Raw. Tajiri somehow kicked out of the gore and the pile driver, but then Rhino picked up his limp body again, a second pile driver, and we've got a new ECW World Television Champion. Rhino, the hand-picked successor to Rob Van Dam, and Van Dam didn't like it one bit. With best friend Scotty Anton watching his back, the whole effing show was face-to-face with the man-beast Rhino again. Rob Van Dam and Rhino face-to-face, toe-to-toe. And down goes Rhino. Rob Van Dam cleared the ring of Rhino. But Rob Van Dam was still not finished. Broken leg and all Van Dam up top.
Rob Van Dam, you may not get a piece of Rhino, but on May the 14th at Hardcore Heaven, your opponent will be the new effing show, Jerry Lynn.
After announcing that Rhino would defend the World Television title against the Sandman at the Hardcore Heaven pay-per-view, he informed Rob Van Dam that his first opponent back would be Jerry Lynn. Jerry Lynn was injured at roughly the same time as Rob Van Dam. Van Dam broke his leg. Jerry Lynn broke his ankle. What a classic they had last year at Hardcore Heaven. They damn near killed each other.
Precision to achieve perfect sense of well-being and
General Hardcore Energy!
Bring natural harmony into your life with ECW. Weekends at 11 on Bravo.
It's extreme.
It's 1 week away. Milwaukee, Sandman, Rhino. I'm gonna show you, Rhino, exactly why everybody in Milwaukee calls me the King of Extreme.
Rob Van Dam.
Hey, Scotty.
It.
You gotta get used to fans coming out to see you now, too, because you are the best friend of Rob Van Dam.
True!
Fans like that. They know we're gonna be giving them a hell of a show. You wanna put me up on your shoulders or something?
May 14th, Hardcore Heaven. I can't wait, Daddy. Pay-per-view, live, buy it now. Don't wait.
Get it this early?
Right now, Daddy.
A lot of RVD fans are concerned that Jerry Lynn might be selling out to the network. Jerry Lynn's saying that he's gonna beat me, Mr. Pay-per-view. Dude, have you gotten into my stash or something? That's crazy. I got the man in my corner watching my back. I got taking care of me so I don't have to worry about anything else, Bill Alfonso.
That will be Fonzie, me, Daddy.
You blow that whistle and I will beat the snot out of Rhino, out of Jack Victory. I'll beat the snot out of Steve Corino, out of Scotty. I'm just joking, Scotty. But I can do that because I'm Rob Van Dam. And Jerry, after I beat the snot out of you, I'm coming after my World Television title.
Perfect.
Because your ass and the World Television title belong to me, everybody's favorite wrestler, and I don't think I have to say the name, but it's really fun, so come on, guys. Rob Van Dam.
May 14th, Hardcore Heaven, the network and Rhino are coming to Milwaukee, the town the Crusher made famous. Another drunk. But we're coming for a drunk of our own. A stinking, disgusting, low-life rummy named the Sandman. Well, Sandman, you're going into Hardcore Heaven and you're going after the one title in ECW that you've never held. The one title that you just love to get your hands on. And I know you'd love to get your stinking hands on me as well. Well, Sandman, you silly, stinking drunk, you may be coming for this title at the pay-per-view. But at the pay-per-view, this man is coming for you.
Sandman! I'm gonna shove a beer can so far up your ass, I'll have to can your head off just to pull it out. And my friend, I will leave the ECW World Television Champion! And you will remember one name.
I've been through wars with the likes of Cactus Jack, barbed wire. I've survived ladders and tables with Sabu. Rhino, what makes you think it's...
Oh, you want to roll? Come on.
Whoa, tough guy. Don't sing it. Swing it.
Sing it. Swing it.
Okay.
Atlanta. Homo.
Sandman, I've got a couple problems. The first problem is you don't drink the beer. The beer drinks you. Second problem, it's a big problem, Sandman. It's me and at Hardcore Heaven. Some say it's the most violent, the most hardcore, the craziest pay-per-view of them all. And Sandman, leave that slut you call a wife at home. It's Mother's Day. Bring your mother. I'll even buy her a front row ticket, and I'll spear her ass through a table! Sandman, after that pay-per-view, your family, you, will always remember the name of the World Television Champion of ECW, and the name is Rhino.
Hello there, young man. You've been lifting some weights. What are you doing?
Yeah, baby, I'm getting ready for my match, man.
Scotty. You don't need to wrestle. It's not about the wrestling. Kid, you've got a gimmick now.
Oh.
And believe me,
the network
when we
right.
unleash the gimmick tonight, the network will be on top once again, just like you and I are going to be on top when we get those ring girls you're auditioning.
Oh, yeah. That's
right. Do the
right.
gimmick for me. Do the gimmick. I love the gimmick. Show me the gimmick.
You mean the clap?
The clap is tremendous.
That's
Let's
it,
go
baby.
To the ring with a clap.
Let's go.
Last week, Raven was put in Scotty Anton's sharpshooter. The U.S. Mail calls it his clapper. Raven tapped and his ankle was so severely injured that Raven is now out of action indefinitely, courtesy of Cyrus, the U.S. Mail, Scotty Anton, and the Oppressive Network. The U.S. Mail, Scotty Anton. Anton had already incensed ECW fans at Hardcore Heaven 2000 when he shoved Rob Van Dam off the top turnbuckle. Jerry Lynn then capitalized two cradle pile drivers. Wait a minute. That's Pierre Ouellette. He was in the back. I saw him lobbying for a job. He's attacking H.C. Long. We were waiting for our next matchup. What the hell is he doing? You know, we really got to improve our recruiting or talent relations or whatever the hell you call it. He could have waited until the end of the evening. We could have set up a meeting. He's been known as Jean-Pierre Lafitte. He was one half of the Quebecers, Pierre. This is all very impressive, but why is he beating up our referee? This is no way to gain favor with a wrestling promotion. Good God! Isn't that enough? I think he just gave H.C. Loke last rites. Why couldn't he have done this to Cyrus? I would have gotten him a job. My God! I guess he scheduled his own tryout match. I don't know what to call him. Jean-Pierre Lafitte, the Quebecer, Carl-Pierre Ouellette. But what the hell is he? And what the hell is going on here? We're here in Danbury, Connecticut. Pitbull number one, Gary Wolf, has returned to take the side of Extreme Championship Wrestling versus the Network's Scotty Anton. Down goes Anton in the corner as Cyrus looks up. Pitbull number one in great shape. Anton set for the ride. Clothesline in the corner. Nowhere for the U.S. Mail to go. Pitbull one now mounting the turnbuckle. Former ECW World Tag Team and Television Champion raining down punches and now driving his boot right to the chest of Scotty Anton. Chop to the midsection. Powerbomb with the 40. Well, fans want to see Pitbull 1 score the pinfall over Scotty Anton, who in recent weeks has become one of the most hated wrestlers we have ever had here at ECW. Pitbull 1 ducks the clothesline, gets caught in the leapfrog and driven into the corner by Scotty Anton. And Anton wants Danbury, Connecticut to get the clap. Sure, he'll do his best to make that happen after the show. Pitbull 1 set for the ride, takes a knee right in the chest. And the U.S. Mail is oh so proud of himself. Down goes Pitbull number one. Scotty Anton making caught here to Sunset Flip. Scotty Anton now picking up Pitbull number one. Irish whip, drop down by Anton, leapfrog as well. Standing drop kick, both feet right in the face. Afraid that clap is kind of contagious. Pitbull 1 set for the ride, ducks the clothesline, full head of steam. Lou Phantom of the challenger, Chris Chetty. Chetty fighting to get back to his feet. He was driven face first into the canvas and hard. There's the Queen of Extreme, Francine, with the steel chair assist to Just Incredible. The steel chair open and set up in the center of the ring. Knife edge chop. Chetty set for the ride. Drop toe hold and Chetty goes face first into the steel chair. Francine applauding from ringside. Just Incredible now. Relentless. Goes right after Chetty. Chetty with two right hands make it three to the midsection of Just Incredible. Face first into the second turnbuckle goes the challenger. Chris Chetty down in the corner. Just Incredible shouting instructions to Francine. Wants her to hold that steel chair in place. It's up against the face of Chris Chetty. And the World Heavyweight Champion drives his knee and the steel chair into the skull of Chetty. Lateral press. Gets it 2.5. Chris Chetty gets that left shoulder up off the canvas. Chetty still swinging away. What a chop! Chetty responds in kind. Just Incredible goes downstairs with a knee. Snapmare on Chetty. And there's the rear chin lock from the World Heavyweight Champion. Just Incredible, riding Chris Chetty on the canvas, gripping the neck, making Chetty fight for each and every breath while essentially giving himself a breather. And Francine is right there to talk trash in the face of Chris Chetty, and that is done by design. Just Incredible always uses the rear chin lock to break down his opponents right in front of Francine, hoping that her big mouth will throw the challengers off their game. And the Francine Fan Club is here in Houston, Texas tonight. Sunset flip. Two count only. Flying clothesline, almost took the head off of Chris Chetty. Just when you think you've got just incredible in trouble, he can be so explosive. Just incredible setting up that steel chair again. This time leaving it closed on the canvas. Right hand between the eyes of the challenger. Just incredible now. Straight rights, throwing right jabs actually. Chris Chetty's up the ride. Nice counter, swinging DDT on the steel chair. But does Chris Chetty have enough to capitalize? Can he cover the World Heavyweight Champion? Is the World Heavyweight Champion stunned enough to stay down for three? Both champion and challenger down on the canvas. Francine trying to rally the fans behind. Just incredible. That is not what's happening. The fans are rallying behind Chris Chetty. Chetty with the right hand, throwing haymakers. Just incredible step to the right. Front kick by Chris Chetty. Beautiful scissor kick to the back of the neck of the World Heavyweight Champion. And Chris Chetty now, setting just incredible for the ride. Upside down goes the World Heavyweight Champion. Back to his feet, back the other way. Reversal, Chetty. Double springboard, side kick, hooks the leg. No, the shoulder comes up. Mike Keener says two only. Clothesline duck, as is the World Heavyweight. Super kick connects. Super kick, lateral press. Chetty gets the shoulder up. Francine complaining of a slow count. That was not the case. Just incredible now picking up Chris Chetty. Reversal. Just incredible hits Francine. Roll up. Shot with the cane. Schoolboy. No. Chris Chetty challenging Just Incredible for the World Heavyweight title from Houston, Texas. Just Incredible gets caught in the middle of his tip-up. There's a schoolboy. In comes Francine to break up the three count. That certainly spoke for itself. Chris Chetty looking for the Amityville Horror. Just Incredible with the front kick. Nice go behind by Chetty. Countering, that's incredible. He's got the World Heavyweight Champion up. Amityville Horror through the table. Cover. No. Chris Chetty was an inch away from becoming the new ECW World Heavyweight Champion. Chris Chetty now on the offensive. Francine looking on from ringside with a very concerned look on her face. Plus, she's still probably a little sore. There's a receipt. Chetty now sore in the lower extremities as well. Just incredible now, looking to capitalize. Oh no, he's got Chetty in position. That's incredible. And thanks to the interference from Francine crushing Chris Chetty on the top turnbuckle, Just Incredible once again escapes. And I'm picking that word very carefully, escapes, still the World Heavyweight Champion. Chris Chetty, with a fine showing of himself, was robbed here tonight in Houston, Texas.
For a little Lucha Libre now here on ECW Hardcore TV, as Psicosis has made his way to the ring here at the Ice Center in Salem, New Hampshire, just 25 minutes north of Boston. Great to have Psicosis back in ECW, where he first made a name for himself here in the United States. Carlos Psicosis is Spanish for psycho. It is the Luchador's opponent here tonight who is in dire need of mental health. The Sinister Minister accompanies Mikey Whipwreck to the ring. Mikey Whipwreck, a triple crown winner here in ECW. Been the world television champion. He's been the world heavyweight champion. Had a title defense, successful title defense against Steve Austin. And he's a three-time ECW World Tag Team Champion, twice with Mick Foley and once recently with Yoshihiro Tajiri under the tutelage of that man, the Sinister Minister. Should be an outstanding athletic contest officiated by referee Mike Keener.
Introducing first, weighing in tonight at 185 pounds, hailing from Tijuana, Mexico, Psicosis! His opponent is accompanied at ringside by the Sinister Minister, weighing in tonight at 187 pounds, hailing from Buffalo, New York, Mikey Whipwreck!
Inside the world's elite fighting force, Saturday at 10:30 on Bravo.
Headlock snatched by Mikey Whipwreck. Psicosis shoots him off. Shoulder block. Mikey now with the full head of steam. No, Mikey puts the brakes on. Dropped down by Psicosis. Mikey catches Psicosis and plants him. Lateral press two. No. Mikey perhaps looking for the pile driver or the power bomb. Psicosis lands on his feet. Knife edge chops. Body scissors. Mikey now with the waist lock. Pair of elbows. Third one misses. Inverted atomic drop. Side Russian leg sweep. Nicely done. Lateral press. Hook of the leg. No. Two count only, says referee Mike Keener. Mikey Whipwreck now shoots Psicosis out of the corner. Psicosis gets the boot up. Nice float over into a DDT out of nowhere. Psicosis now ascending the turnbuckles. Leaping Houdankon Rana, Mikey Whipwreck rolls all the way to the outside. Keep your eye on Psicosis. Up and over. Remember, we're in an ice rink. We're at the ice center. Nothing but boards covering hard, cold, unforgiving ice. Mikey Whipwreck currently in a bad way. Psicosis now up on the ring apron. Psicosis gets caught and rammed throat first on top of the steel guard rail. And the minister digs his claws, his talons into Psicosis. Psicosis now driven backwards into the steel guardrail. Mikey Whipwreck recently has been competing mostly in tag team competition. Yoshihiro Tajiri became World Tag Team Champions, winning the World Tag Team Title Tournament at the Hammerstein Ballroom in New York City. They were defeated the very next evening for the belts by the FBI. What a decapitated clothesline cover to no. Mikey and Tajiri will challenge for the belts they lost in New York City. They will once again face the full-blooded Italians at the Anarchy Rules pay-per-view. Mikey set his head too soon and paid for it. Spinning heel kick connects. Both boots to the side of the head. Psychosis says that's all. Mikey Whipwreck now being set up. Psychosis now going up top with Mikey. Trying to hook Mikey. Whippersnapper! Whippersnapper! It's over!
Your winner of the match, Mikey Whipwreck!
Will Mikey be a four-time World Tag Team Champion at Anarchy Rules? One thing is for sure, Mikey will still be disturbed between now and the Anarchy Rules pay-per-view. What goes through the mind of Mikey Whipwreck? Mikey extending a hand to Psychosis.